Hello friends, the National Library of Ayurveda Medicine is pleased to present a new episode on Ayurveda. The present release is part of a video lecture series prepared for the education of Ayurveda literature in accordance with the academic curriculum of Ayurveda studies in India. My name is Dr. Sumit Kesarkar and I will be your host throughout this video, which gives a brief explanation of the interrelationships between the subdoshas. The 15 subdosha have a corresponding relationship with each other and carry on the balancing act of Vata, Pitta and Kapha at the micro level in a similar way as found at the macro level. Though in general it's the action of the three prime doshas, understanding the relation between subtypes makes it simpler to treat disorders. The subtype relationship is as follows. Pranavayu, Sadak Pitta, Tarpak Kapha. Udanavayu, Alochak Pitta, Bodhak Kapha. Samanavayu, Pachak Pitta, Kletak Kapha. Vyanavayu, Bhrajak Pitta, Shleshak Kapha. Apanavayu, Ranjak Pitta, Avulambak Kapha. Samanavayu, Pachak Pitta and Kletak Kapha aid in the digestive process and are located mainly in the stomach and small intestine. Vyanavayu, Bhrajak Pitta and Shleshak Kapha relate to the limbs, the skin, the joints and the surface of the body and are connected to a power of circulation. Apanavayu, Ranjak Pitta and Avalambak Kapha play a supportive role for the other doshas and are mainly related to the internal organs like kidney, liver and heart. They govern the waste products of the doshas. Apanavayu governs intestinal excretion. Ranjak Pitta governs the excess of blood and bile, while Avalambak Kapha governs excess of mucus in the chest and lungs. Udanavayu, Alochak Pitta and Bodhak Kapha are in the head, face, mouth and neck and relate to sensory activity. They improve sensory perception, increase will and aspiration and help raise the functioning of the other forms of the same dosha. Pranavayu, Sadak Pitta and Tarpak Kapha relate to the brain, heart, spine, nervous system function and have a controlling action on the other of the five forms of their respective dosha. Prana is increased by the practice of pranayama and by the creation of a positive attitude and positive will in life. Sadak Pitta is increased by the practice of discrimination and by clarity of perception. Tarpak Kapha is increased by the practice of contentment and by faith in life. Pranavayu, Sadak Pitta and Tarpak Kapha are related to Prana, Tejas and Ojas and can also be increased through the factors that increase Prana, Tejas and Ojas. These treatment factors will be discussed later in a separate video concerned with spiritual healing. We should always consider these relationships when treating any subdosha. For example, when dealing with Shleshak Kapha as in case of arthritis, we should consider the role of Vyanavayu as peripheral energy flow and Bhrajak Pitta as surface heat as well. Generally, we should also try to increase the power of the subtle forms of the doshas and decrease that of their grossier forms. I hope this video was informative and made the subject clear. Comments and feedback are highly appreciated and you can leave them by visiting the National Library's website at www.nlam.in. or likewise by writing to me at vdsumit@gmail.com. Thank you for watching.